Hello, Aries. Welcome to February 2021 love reading. Because it's the month of love, we had to do the love reading separately for each sign. So I divided cards into halves. This side is the divine feminine, the kitty cat over there. The stone, rose quartz stone, they're both rose quartz. This side is the divine masculine. So it doesn't matter which one you are. One of you is probably Aries. And how it works is I'm going to take a look at what is going on with her, what is going on with him, what is going on in the relationship, or if you are still not in a relationship, what is going on before you guys meet. Okay. In the center here, I have the card Peace. This is the overall energy. It says hug your confusion. Try to feel peace by the thought that you do not know all the answers. So you don't need to know all the answers. You don't need to know everything in your life. You don't need to be in control of everything in your life. The important thing is that you find your inner peace. Okay. I want to go closer to the cards. I hope I can get it. But you can see all in all, yeah? So here I have the Four of Pentacles. Four of Pentacles is someone who keeps their energy, their money, their time to themselves. Okay, so she is focusing on herself. She is not ready to open up. She is maybe taking care of her own body with the star here, taking care of her inner self, you know, just to feel good. She probably does feel this peace, but at the same time, it's kind of like she's focusing only on herself and not trying to see the other people. So if the divine feminine, I'm talking to you right now, if you are single, the way that you're going to attract your partner, your divine masculine over there, is by opening up, okay? It's good that you are practicing self-love. This is great. You might be also unemployed currently, or I don't know, just something, Knight of Pentacles. There is some sort of stagnation over there going on. Maybe you've been in this energy long enough. Hangman is now in reverse. Yeah, so you did what you could. Now it's time maybe to start to open up, or keep your peace, keep it to yourself until you feel you are ready. If you don't feel you're ready, okay, be where you are. Don't worry, nothing lasts forever. The only thing I would advise you to find balance, because here we have this Temperance. You have to really find balance between give and take, between outside and inside world, between how much you keep to yourself and how much you open up to the world. The Hermit here is suggesting, yes, stay a bit alone, but this I would think it's more about the divine masculine. So let's go to the divine masculine. His current position is a mess. I'm not trying to even be sarcastic, it's actually true. Because here we have this Seven of Swords. Then we have Ten of Pentacles reversed. Seven of Swords is all about dishonesty, theft, just doing something behind someone's back, or being dishonest to somebody, or just trying to use and abuse the situation. It must be connected with money somehow. Yeah, maybe he's trying to make money in an illegal way. He's trying to get away from it. He's trying to be better. He's trying to better himself, but something is still holding him back. He thinks that without this, without his scamming ways, he cannot contribute to the world, or he cannot he has nothing to offer, or he cannot get what he wants in life. Which I would say in the contrary. Come on. Come on. Like, you will get nothing but bad karma over there. And just cut it. cut it out, Divine Masculine. You have to stop this. You have to stop it sooner or later, because if you don't stop it, it's going to be stopped by the divine force, okay? then you have to be careful, okay? Let's see what is the, if you are in a relationship, what is the deal here? So, all in all, the truth will come out. The truth is coming out. Whatever he's been doing and maybe didn't tell her about it, it will come out, and there's gonna have to be some compromise needed. There's gonna have to be some deep talk about where all this is going and whether he wants to continue with his crazy ways or not. Whatever he's confused there about needs to come out and needs to stop at some point. With the Five of Wands, this could mean that you take the advantage of the situation. Yes, take the advantage, stop fighting, stop bickering, stop resisting and conflicting. Just try to take the advantage, tell the truth, and try to find the middle way about when it comes to the conflict that you guys have, if you are together and if you have a conflict. If not, then great, then everything is okay. Because peace is here in the middle, yeah? We do not forget that. You need to create some sort of peace, some sort of balance, so that your ways are not anymore... Because when you are lying or scamming or hiding something or doing something that is not supposed to be done, you're always nervous that you're gonna get caught. You're always nervous. You could get snappy. You could get... just, it's stress. The first price you pay is stress. And then there is, if they catch you, there is more prices to pay. You need to get away from it and stay alone for a while, Divine Masculine. You need to get your peace, your own, your nirvana, whatever it is. Just get peace in your mind, first of all. There could be some short-term sickness or short-term inconvenience happening, but this short-term is not going to be too big. Yeah, it's not a tower full-on, it's tower reversed. This short-term creates a new opportunity, creates a surprise, creates something totally different what you've been expecting, because this one here is deciding whether to go this way or that way. But in reverse, it's not going to be not that way, not this way. It's going to be something totally else. So if you're expecting to meet your love, there's going to be something totally else and something totally a big surprise for you, okay? Dear Aries, also what I see is that, yeah, when it comes to meeting the one, when if you are still not together, like this lady here, I see she is kind of patient. She's patient. He might not be as patient. Or he might not even think about love at the moment, because he's thinking about all other craziness. So stay patient a little longer, Divine Feminine, until he figures out his ways. Yeah, because in the bottom of the deck, we had lovers in reverse. We also had this reversed. Oh my God, look. Oh my God, the crazy stuff is happening right now in the bottom of the deck. Bottom is speaking because lovers in reverse, so it's not a good time to create unions, or maybe it's not a good time for the union. Then this one, yeah, he's just not satisfied wherever he is. And he needs to move on. He needs to overcome this. That's why he is not right now ready for love. And the judgment in reverse, oh my God, when he gets the pay, when he pays the price of his crazy doings, then he pays off the karma, and then you see the Wheel of Fortune turns and everything changes, and then the new chapter begins with the High Priestess. It's more in tune, it's more in alignment with your personal path, with yourself, okay? This is talking about the divine masculine, so divine feminine, please stay patient a little longer. I have also the oracle cards. First of all, I want to mention that these cards, they came out, I think, in 2012. I remember when they came out. Then Doreen, this is by Doreen Virtue. She was still in Hay House back then, and she still did these cards, and right now she's not doing it anymore. She's pulling back all her name from all the cards. But I remember every Valentine's Day, these cards were free on the Hay House website to use online, you know. You can still go to their website. There, the Colette Baron Reid, she has some free cards to use. I think Radley Valentine has some free cards to use online too. So it's fun. I love these cards. And that's why, because now it's February, I get nostalgic about the old times when those cards just came out. But this message here is for the Divine Feminine. And the next is for Divine Masculine. It says, love yourself first. Yes, your self-respect will magnify your attractiveness. So, yes, care about yourself, about your appearance, about your energy, about your... even your charisma needs sometimes some renovation, maybe. Yeah, work on that resting bitch face. Just love yourself first and just care about yourself at this point. Even if you are in a stagnation period, use it for bettering yourself. This guy here, oh my God, true love and passion. So he might know you already. He might know who you are. He might like you already. He might feel something towards you. And this is true love and passion. And then we had a card like express your love. If you guys already know each other, this is amazing. It's like tell each other how you feel. Why not? Why not? February is the perfect month to do so. Okay? Express your love. If not, if you don't know each other, then what you could do is to try to express your need for love, or express that you want to attract someone. Yeah, you can make spells, some love spells, love magic, who knows. All in all, with the Fate card here, when we go into a relationship, meaning of this card is all about accepting yourself, but at mostly accepting the other person for who they are, for what they are, not trying to change them, not trying to rush them. Everyone is on their journey and the Fate will take care of it, okay? It's just about accepting the moment and being in the moment. The next thing, you guys, no matter how long you are together, you don't know everything about each other. And this is what keeps it interesting. This is what keeps it, you know, together. And everyone is a treasure on its own, and you have to rediscover that. And now if you go deep into your partner, and you can discover something very beautiful about them that you haven't known. Okay, try to see them with the new eyes every day. It will spice up your love life as well. And don't forget to express your love, tell them you love them. Okay, so that is about it for February love, Aries. Thank you for coming up this far. You can subscribe here and stay tuned with my next readings. Check out the February horoscopes if you haven't. Check out the love reading for the entire year. I also have that one, and I also have the entire year reading for Aries sign. Okay, so yeah, push me a like. Thank you and bye bye.